My name is Sammy Dash, White Private Eye in Mumubuti, Africa. When millionaire Howard H. Farnsworth hired me to find the Jungle Queen, that's when it all started. Farnsworth seemed a little strange when he stepped into my office. After he advanced me a good chunk of dough, I took the job. I left Farnsworth at the railroad station and started into the jungle to find the queen. A couple of days into my search, I came across this pygmy village. The chief dressed up in a six-button bennies, looking like a cool fool in the water pool. Must have been no bigger than 2'6". In big names, I asked him. About to leave, his bird sound cut through me like a slug of a 45. To find that bird meant to find the queen. I moved into the marshes with a jungle steam. Again, that bird sound whistled through. I was pushing the plane down, that I knew. The pygmies frozen in terror started to dash with the kind of cuckoo and cha-cha. Were biting me all over. The leeches were sucking my blood. Again I heard the sound of the bird down deep in the heart of the woods. I finally left the marshes and made it to some flatlands. Now, thinking and battered, my French coat was tattered, my fedora was all in a stretch. I stumbled through the jungle, trying not to take a tumble, to find where that bird led. Then it happened. I saw this weird-looking bird. It flew round and round, very close to the ground, till it finally boomed with shelter. Too tired out to call about, I kept in mind the pygmy rhyme. It was now still. I pulled out my 45 and entered the hut. I held my rod tightly in my sweaty hands so no one could grab it. And there it was, the Jungle Queen. I had found the jungle. The queen, mumbling something, took my rod and wouldn't let go. She was trying to say, "Loving you means never having to say you're sorry." All right, Wayne, drop my rod.